say bye-bye, Bunny.
Habit.
Now it's over to Addy and Anna for lovely exchange.
How you doing?
Sorry. As you can see, I've got my silky smooth footy skills out for you.
Yeah, with those footy skills, you could be in any Premiership team, Anna.
Oh, really?
Not.
Oh, well, if you are wondering why we're doing all this footy business, then you better hang around for the rest of the show.
Yes, this week is Footy Week on Xchange, and to celebrate, we've got Blackburn Rovers midfield maestro David Dunn in the Xchange studio.
And if that wasn't enough talent, we've got dynamic duo Gemini, who are the British entry at this year's Eurovision Song Contest. They'll be performing their song for Europe.
Hi, guys. As you know, we are well into our search for our most talented teachers in the country. And today, I'm at St Catherine's School in Bristol, because they're Year 17. They've got a couple of teachers that are a cut above the rest. So join me, join them, and join him a little bit later. What are you doing, hot dog?
Tony, and it is definitely a jam-packed show for you because we are joined by our first guests. We've got Gemini. Hello.
Hello.
We've got Chris and Gemma. It's lovely to meet you. Now, you are the UK's entrance into the Eurovision Song Contest. That's brilliant. You're going to be performing your single, Cry Baby, which is out on...
26th of May.
The 26th of May, so good luck for that. But I just want to know, how did this all come about?
We entered the Song for Europe competition on BBC One.
Oh, but you know what? We've actually got a clip of it, and this is the bit where you won the Song for Europe. It's brilliant. Oh.
They say number one should be song number one.
Song that goes forward to Riga in Latvia on the 24th of May to sing for the United Kingdom at the Eurovision Song Contest. The writer is Martin Isherwood. The singers are Gemini. They're taking the stage.
Yeah! Can you just reenact that, please? Me like that? Can I just say you look very starry with the glasses? You look absolutely brilliant. What did it feel like?
Amazing.
Best day, wasn't it? It was fantastic.
Absolutely amazing. We just couldn't believe it. Like,
we were crying about 2 hours later.
We were confident all the way through. And when the results actually got announced, we were just like, oh my God, couldn't believe
it. Did it make you smile?
Yes, definitely.
Absolutely. Would you know
about
what?
3 days.
That moves us smoothly on to today's big one because it's National Smile Week. So we're going to be asking you exchanges and you guys, what makes you smile and why? So have you got anything that makes you smile? Obviously, winning the Song for Europe.
Chris makes me smile. No, he makes me laugh, actually.
My mum makes me smile.
That's really
sweet. She's daft. She just does the stupidest things.
And Chris has a good smile as well, see his teeth.
That's really good.
Oh, and
his new teeth.
Well, do you know what? Chocolate makes me smile. But you know what? We want to know what you guys make, what makes you guys smile. And if you think you know, then simply get in touch because we want to hear from you. Remember to leave your name and your number and your email details as well so we can get back in touch with you. Now, we've also got another special guest. We've got the David Dunn. He's a top footballer. He's going to be in. So remember to get your questions in for him because he's going to be answering them for you a little bit later on. But hey, you're going to be performing your single, Cry Baby, a little bit later on. I can't wait for that. But hey, he's going to be ideas at all because I thought, gorgeous girl is going to be with you. But he's not, he's disappeared. Where's he gone?
I'm here. Yep, it's footy week all week this week. And it doesn't get much better than that, but it's about to get better for one lucky exchange viewer as I announce the winner of this weekend's competition. Now, this weekend, Tony was on top of a roof, and the question he asked is, what could he see? The answer is a pyramid, of course. There you go. Now, if your name is Hessen Arter from Durham, well done, because you've won yourself all those wicked goodies. Lovely. Now, but the prizes don't stop there because there's much more because it's our new footy competition.
Great shot. It's a...
Yes, we're having it larger Xchange this week because we're celebrating the fact that it's the FA Cup this weekend. And we're also celebrating the fact that the Brazilian commentators are the king of commentary. And if you don't believe me, check out this clip from the 1994 World Cup.
Romário. 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 Boa bola pro Bebeto. Faz, Bebeto. Faz! Faz! Gol!
Yes, that man was truly having it large. That was Luciano Dovale, and his shout lasted 11 seconds. But you know what? I know our Xchange viewers can do better than that, because I know you guys have got skills. Now, every day this week, we're giving you the chance to shout goal. Now, whoever shouts goal the longest in the week will win these heavy prizes. Yes, it's a signed shirt from Onwankulkanu, signed shirt from BT, and James BT, and a signed boots as well. Wicked prizes. Yes, now, who have we got online? We've got Charlie online. How you doing, Charlie? What's up? How you doing, mate? Which team do you support?
I support Manchester United.
Manchester United, the champions. Well, congratulations for this season. You lot have done well. Now, I'm going to show you a clip from a game from Southampton versus Tottenham Hotspur. And the goal scorer is Anders Svensson. And I want you to shout goal as soon as the ball crosses the line. Is that clear?
Yeah.
OK, let's get running. Run the clip, please.
He's going up, and it looks like he could beat this one defender, and he's in, and it's a goal!
Go on! Keep it going! Keep it going! Oh, yes! Superb! That was 10 seconds, Charlie. You almost lasted as long as that Brazilian commentator. Well done. Now, I'm going to put you up on the scoreboard. You are currently first because you are our first caller. And if you win at the end of this week, you could get those wicked prizes. Nice one, Charlie.
Woo!
Take it easy, mate. Nice one. Now, if you guys feel you've got a big enough gob or big enough lungs to play the game and you could shout goal for longer than Charlie, then get in contact. Contact us on this number up here in the corner, and please get permission before you email, text or call from the person who's got the skills to pay the bills. But now it's time, I think, we headed over to Anna to see if she's on the ball.
Oh, hey, good shot there. Do you know what? I am very excited because I am joined today by Blackburn Rovers and England midfielder David Dunn. He's in the house. How you doing? You all right?
How you doing?
Oh, it's lovely to meet you. Now, can I just say a massive well done for the victory against Spurs at the weekend. Did it make you smile?
It did, yeah. I only played the second half, but it was a good result for all the team.
Yeah, well, second half, it's better than, just nothing.
Yeah, of course.
Being on the bench. But you know what? We've actually got a clip of you in action, so let's check this out.
David Dunn for 3-1. It's Dunn with the curling shot. What a free kick. They reckon at Blackburn that he's a wonderful prospect, David Dunn.
David spitting on the pitch. David, very uncouth.
It was disgusting.
But how does it feel to actually score a goal like that?
Ah, it's brilliant. Yeah, it's really good.
And how do you cope with all the crowds around you? Do you zone them out or do you know that they're there?
Yeah, you don't really. When you're concentrating that much on playing football, you don't really notice the crowd.
That must be mad because there's thousands and thousands of people screaming your name.
Yeah.
But so a lot of pressure.
Yeah, it is, but yeah, like I say, you don't really notice them.
You're just too cool, aren't you?
No.
But you know what? We've got Helen online, she's a top fan. Hello, Helen.
Hi.
Hello, have you got a question for David?
Yeah.
Go for it then.
Of the 8 goals you scored this season, which has pleased you most and why?
Hi, Helen.
Hi.
You alright?
Yeah.
It's probably the Leeds goal because I missed the penalty at Manchester United, so it was good to get up there again and score a penalty against Leeds.
Alright.
All right.
Oh, thanks for calling in, Helen.
Right. Thank you.
Not a problem. Hey, Addy, you all right?
Hey, how you doing, David?
What's happening, mate?
Nice one, well, right. Wicked. Now, before we grill you with any more questions, it's time for us to find out the results of our highly sophisticated blow football prediction.
Yeah, and also you can give us the analysis on the results as well, if that's all right.
Yes. Okay. Yep. On Friday, Everton's biggest fan, Lee McGowan, came into the studio. He was representing Everton, and he played blow football against Mark Lawrenson, and Lawrenson was Man U, and he blew him off the pitch. The score was 3-1, but the actual score on Sunday was 2-1 to Man United, which was a good result for you guys, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. That meant we got in Europe again, so that was good.
Cool. It's got you into the UEFA Cup, hasn't it?
That's right, yeah.
Nice one.
Ooh, but
nice,
you know what? We've got another caller on the line for you. We've got Roger. Hello, Roger.
Hello.
Hey, have you got a question for David?
Yeah. Hey, David. What's it like to play with Duff, Tuga and other international players?
Yeah, it's really good. They certainly bring you on as a player as well, so hopefully there'll be a few more signings in the summer and hopefully we'll all stick together.
Brilliant.
Thanks.
No problem. Thanks, Roger. Thanks for calling.
Nice one. Good question. Now I've got a question for you. Played for England, that must have been amazing. What was it like for you?
That was brilliant, yeah. I think as a young lad you always dream of playing for your country, so to actually achieve that and step out there in, you know, in front of all the fans with such good players is it was a dream come true, yeah.
You're going to keep carrying on playing for them?
Fingers crossed. Hopefully, yeah. Hopefully if I keep playing well for the club and hopefully I'll get a few more chances.
Well, it was nice talking to you today, but quickly, on this weekend's FA Cup, who do you reckon is going to win?
Hopefully Southampton, because I've got two mates that are playing for Southampton, so I'll be going down as well. I'm going down to watch it.
Oh, yeah.
So hopefully we'll come.
Excellent. Well, do you know what? Whatever the outcome, I just know that there'll be a lot of talent on the pitch. And talking of talent, Tony and the Hot Dog are in Bristol at St Catherine's School on a talent troll, so let's catch up with them.
Just having a cup of tea at St Catherine's School. Now, we're trying to find the talented teachers, but they're not ready for us yet, are they? They're just warming up.
Yeah.
Warming up, eh?
Ready for you.
Oh, ready for us now, then.
Yeah, wonderful.
Come on, then. Miss Bird and Miss Elliot. Is that you two? OK, well, you guys have been nominated as talented teachers. What is your talent and what are you going to do for
us
today?
We are extremely talented at dancing to ABBA's Dancing Queen.
OK, well, listen, you guys get prepared for the performance of a lifetime while Hot Dog finds out what your Year 7s think of you guys.
Yeah, I got to find out, what do you think about these marvellous costumes?
They're all right. I reckon they're going to do really well.
Okay, and have you ever seen your teacher singing before? What's it like?
It seems really odd, but I think they're going to do great. Good luck.
Oh, there we go. Good luck.
That's it. All right, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Please get ready, get excited, and can I have the drum roll, please? It's time for Miss Bird and Miss Elliot with Dancing Queen by ABBA! Listen, how many of you Year 7s think you could do better than them?
Yeah!
OK, we will find out a little bit later on the show. Back to you guys in the studio.
I'm not too sure about that talent show and that dancing queen stuff. I've got to put up with Anna, man. But now, here's something else that really made me smile. And it was a dream come true when I got that to go down and meet my heroes at West Ham to see what it was like to work behind the scenes at a Premiership team. West Ham, my favourite football club. And as their biggest fan, I got the privilege of meeting one of their most powerful figures. The man who's the driving force behind the players. The man who puts fire in their bellies and rocket fuel in their boots. Hello, Tim.
Hello,
how you
Eddie.
Doing, mate?
How are you? You all right?
Nice to meet you. Well, I'm here to help. What can I do, mate?
If you get yourself over here and you can help me cook the salad.
Wicked. I'll cook a mean beans a la toast, mate.
Let's go for it.
All right, so we're going to be chopping the vegetables. Will this do as a knife?
I don't think so, Eddie. I think you better use this one.
You must get to work closely with the players,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah.
Do you know them well?
Yeah, I'm beginning to get to know him quite well now.
Does Di Canio like his alphabet and spaghetti?
Just Di Cecchio pasta.
Di Cecchio pasta. I bet you David James eats a lot. He's the tallest player out of them.
Yeah, I think David's about 6'6". So yeah.
6'6".
Yeah, so he eats a fair amount of food.
Yeah.
And a lot of cups of teas as well.
Cole! He makes it 3.
And I bet you Cole, he looks like so. I bet you he sneaks the odd bit of chocolate here and there.
Might do.
You know, Jermaine Defoe, I reckon he looks like the sort that start a food fight, mate.
Jay can put a lot of food away.
He's
a keen eater.
Yeah?
He likes to eat as much as he can possibly get in there.
So what do you reckon to my technique?
That's it.
How come mine isn't as fine and stylish as yours?
It's just 15 years practice.
So why is your job so important to him?
Well, you've got to give all these players the right food, because if they don't get the right food, they're not going to perform properly. So it's my job to give them their daily intake of nutrients.
So a basic diet of marshmallows isn't going to work?
No, not at all. Come on, I'll show you what I mean. First thing is carbohydrates.
Mm-hmm.
So we do lots of pasta every day. Next thing is protein, and then vitamins. And the last ingredients is we've got water.
Hang about, is that West Ham water?
It's West Ham holy water.
This is the actual West Ham water. What's that over there?
What's that?
So, like, tell me, being a football fanatic, how good is it to have a job working in a football team?
Oh, it's great. I get a buzz out of it because I'm a West Ham supporter as well, so...
Like me.
That's it. Just to go out there and watch the guys, you know, winning the games is what it's all about.
Winning the games and knowing they eat your pasta.
That's it. OK, Eddie, we better start getting the food ready for the players, because they'll be in a second. And that's it.
Salted. Whoever gets to eat this culinary masterpiece is definitely in for a treat. They won't leave the table hungry. Lovely. It's the attacking midfield genius, Trevor Sinclair. I can't believe it. He is going to love it. I'm telling you, right, he may have skills, but he doesn't understand cordon bleu cooking.
Vomit.
Oh, get out of here. Listen, right, it was great because I even managed to get away with this wicked West Ham plate as a souvenir.
Have you stolen that?
No, I've acquired it. In East London, we acquire it. Look, you know what I mean?
Anyway, it's time to reveal our Mark Lawrenson competition, the winner of. Now, whoever wins the competition will win these prizes. It's a soccer star ball. No, it's not a soccer star ball. What is it?
It's a swing ball.
And a rucksack. It's a pretty cool prize. Too cool for me to remember.
Yes, and the question we wanted to know is, when Mark Lawrenson was playing internationally, which national team did he play for? Was it England, Scotland or Ireland? And I think David knows the answer.
Ireland.
Hey!
There you go. Now, if your name's Abby Edie and you're from Hartwell, get cheering because you've won those prizes. Go, girl.
Go, girl. But hey, it's time for today's daily footy competition because top BBC commentator John Motson, he's going to be testing you to see if you can guess the mystery footballer. What are you doing?
Hold on.
But anyway, you could win these fantastic prizes. It's a nice silver football and a mini camera. Will you get off my show? Yeah, what are you doing?
I reckon your shoe will help me tune this in because Laura's got a live lift from Cardiff for the Millennium.
It's a lovely sunny day here. I am going to give you some clues. See if you can guess who this player is. Now, he has scored an awful lot of goals this season. He does play at top level in this country, and he wears the number 14 shirt. I'd also tell you that he was born in August 1977. I'm not going to tell you where, because that might be a clue as well. And he's also won two major awards this season for over 30 goals altogether. That's in full competition this season, of course. And one last bit of information. He has also played for two clubs, two very well-known clubs, outside the UK.
Do you know what? That footballer definitely has va-va-voo. But hey, the clues are A, David Seaman, B, Thierry Henry, Or C, Arsene Wenger. Shut it, Addo.
You pronounced it right.
I pronounced it right. And maybe this scarf as well. It's not yours, is it?
No, pass it,
yeah. It's Joe's Arsenal scarf.
That's what I do to the Arsenal one.
I can't believe you did that. Well, anyway, if you think you know the answer, then just call us on these numbers. Get off.
Want to get in touch? Well, here's how. Check with the person who pays the bill and get dialing on 0845 900 2222. Or why don't you text us on 07736 222211, where you charge the usual text rate. You can also log on to our website at www.bbc.co.uk/CBC and then click on Xchange. Go on, we want to hear what you have to say.
But hey, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. You met them earlier. It's Gemini with their brand new single. It's their entry in the UK Eurovision Song Contest. It's Cry Baby.
To you guys on Saturday, the 24th of May in Riga, Latvia.
I'm really sorry.
Anna, you need to work on those skills.
Actually, you do have a point, but I've got no one to teach me all those snazzy moves, have
I? No worries, girl, because you've got to check out my mate who's going to be teaching us some freestyling tricks every day of this week.
Mate?
Yeah, it's my mate, Colin.
Hello, my name is Colin Nell. And I am the football freestyler. That means whenever I get hold of a football, I perform amazing football tricks that you could practice. There are no rules to freestyle. Your style, any style. Be creative, have fun, and work hard. Wanna learn how? I'll show you. This is around the world, and this is a real crowd pleaser. Missed it? I'll show you again. Think it looks hard? There's nothing to it. Catch the ball on your foot, then flick it up and kick your foot over the ball, ready to catch it coming down. Catch the ball on your foot, then flick it up and kick your foot over the ball. Learn that and you'll be king of the streets.
Skills,
but Emmy's my mate as well.
I can't believe that. You have mates in high places. I'm but I want to know, David, can you do that?
Hey.
Go on then. Oh,
no.
Come on.
No. Come on, David. You can do it. And again.
Roll it in. Has he got one more go? Quick go.
Little one.
What are you trying to do anyway?
Really? That's what I'm talking about. The man has got skills. Big up, David. And speaking of people with skills, here's Tony and the hot dog at St. Catherine's School.
Oh, welcome back to St. Catherine's School in Bristol. Earlier on, we saw Miss Bird and Miss Elliot doing their rendition of ABBA. And frankly, I wasn't that impressed. So let's see if the Year 7s here can do a little better. Hot dog, what do they need to know?
I need to know that today I gotta be impressed. If it's not good, and I mean brilliant, people, you're in the bun.
Ooh, the hot dog is not in a great mood today. Let's see if our first contestant can put a smile on his face. So what are your names and what are you doing for us?
We're Lucy and Louise and we're doing a rap.
Take it away.
I'm an MC back on TVC.
We're on TV, so let us be.
I'm an
HR rapper. Okay. You are brilliant. You are rubbish. You're going in the bun. In you go.
Ooh, in the bun she goes. Okay, next up, who have we got and what are you going to do for us?
I'm Ben and I'm going to do a dance.
Take it away, Ben.
Whoa. Wonderful, Ben. You're through, mate.
Ben's through. Next up. What's your name and what are you doing for us?
I'm Alice and I'm singing a song.
Take it away.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain.
In the bun.
Oh, in the bun she goes.
Get it.
Oh, the gunks are flying. Okay, what are your names? What are you doing for us?
I'm Nicola and this is Jolene and we're doing gymnastics.
Take it away.
Wow, that's very good. She was great, you're rubbish. You're going in the bun.
Ooh, I remember when trying gymnastics at home, be very, very careful, they are trained. Next up, what's your name and what are you going to do for us?
My name's Amy and I'm going to do a poem.
Take it away, Amy.
I eat my peas. I eat my peas with honey. I've done it all my life. It makes my peas taste funny, but it keeps them on my
nose. Lovely, you're through.
Oh, she's through. Okay, next up, what's your name and what are you doing for us?
I'm Lily and I'm reading a rhyme.
Take it away.
I had a little bug, as cute can be. I put him in my pocket while I ate my tea. Jumped onto
You're going in the bun. You're going in the bun.
Oh, she's going in the bun. Well, that's it. That is it. It's all the talent we have got time for today. It has been awesome down here at St. Catherine's. Big up for St. Catherine's School. I just hope that you there in the studio were suitably impressed, were you?
You're going in the bun, you're going in the bun, Anna, not David Dunn, you're going in the bun. Were you guys impressed?
Yes. Impressed? Definitely. We all were. you're chuckling. Anyway, we've got some big one emails here.
Yes.
Now, we've been asking you what makes you smile and why. I never actually asked you, did I? So what is that?
Chocolate.
Chocolate, you're like me. Easily pleased. You're like to win the Eurovision. You're going to go and do it, aren't you? Excellent. Now we've got one here from Nicola, and it says, Xchange makes me smile.
Oh.
I'm liking that one. And another one here from Victoria, Vicstar, in fact, says, football makes me smile. Quite apt for this week.
Yep,
brilliant. Keep them coming in.
Yeah, keep them coming in because we will be reading them out all week, won't we?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Now, thank you to our guests because it's nearly the end of the show. Thank you, Gemini. Big up.
Now, your single Cry Baby, when's it coming out?
26th of May.
26th
of May.
Well, good luck with that and wish you all the best back in the Eurovision Song Contest. And also, David Dunn, thank you so much for coming.
Big up!
Brilliant. Good luck with your career, yeah?
And there'll be more footy madness with some real football mascots next. Thank you for watching. Whatever you do, stay safe. Peace from Xchange!
See ya.